So here's what we're going to be going over here today. This is the 20, yeah, I think it's 20 tree drip irrigation kit from Drip Depot. Now, I don't have 20 trees I'm going to be doing, but we have all these different planter beds here, as well as the different containers. So the whatever I don't use for the apple trees, I'm going to use for the garden. So there's going to be other stuff I have to buy here, but this is what we have. So I upgraded and got 200 feet of half inch main line. There's, I think it's, what is this? 100 feet of quarter inch. And then there is another 100 feet here of what's actually called dripper line. So this has holes in it every 6 inches. So this, what we'll do is put around the base of the tree. So this goes around the size of the root ball so that when you're, when it's running, it's gonna soak the entire area. Then you have stakes for the lines, and then you have a bunch of different fittings. You have T fittings, you have union connections, you have some 90 degree fittings for the half inch line, union couplers, and then you have a pressure regulator. So because you don't wanna run too much pressure through this line, you wanna be you know, just about right. So the one that I got is for 25 PSI. Then you have the little punch tool. So this will take the quarter inch and allow you to connect it to the half inch through all the different connectors here. And I'll show how you, all of this works. So there's different kits like this that you can get. And like I said, I'm gonna be piecemealing everything for the garden that's behind me. And then from Amazon, I picked up a Orbit Beehive automatic hose faucet timer. So this one's Bluetooth, but you can get a Wi-Fi adapter for it as well. Okay, so now that I've gone over all the different parts of the system, let's actually go out and install it. This is the half inch line, and this is what's gonna actually run around the house. But to be able to actually run this decently, we have to uncoil this. And one of the easiest ways to do so is to uncoil it out in the sun and let it lay for a while, let the plastic relax so you can actually form it around. Otherwise, you're dealing with coils. So we'll do this with the half inch, and I'll also do it with the quarter inch. All right, so for the quarter inch, we gotta do the same thing. Well, that didn't work out. Now I gotta figure out how to uncoil it. What the? This was supposed to be easy. Oh my God, I actually have a knot. Okay, so now that I untangled that mess, I'm gonna let this sit like this for a couple hours, and then we'll come back this evening and start actually doing the install work.
Many hours later.
So right here's the hose bib that we're gonna be using to actually feed the trees. So this is where the timer's gonna be, and then it's going to run down through this. It's gonna come back along the back of the house here. Ignore all this nasty stuff because we just haven't landscaped yet. So it's gonna go around the corner here. It's gonna go down the side of the house here. This is about 40 feet. And then go a little bit along the driveway right down here. Then we're gonna come across to where our four red delicious apple trees are. So here's the final assembly of the bib adapter, the pressure regulator, the filter, and then the 90 degree connection I have here that's gonna go to the half inch drip line. So all we're gonna do here, just so I know that this is going to work, is we're just gonna tie this right on to the hose bib. Screw that on there. And then make sure that the direction of my fitting is going the way the line's gonna go. Now I just have to pull the line from that end of the house to here so we can make this connection. So this is nothing more than just a compression fitting. So if your half inch putt line is a little cold, either set it out in the sun or warm it up with some hot water. But then all you have to do is really push this on here. Like that. then just tighten up the compression fitting. This is a temporary installation for this line, so I'm not too concerned about making this look pretty right now. I'll do that some other time. So I've rounded the corner here. I'm going to take it down this side of the house behind the trash cans. And actually down the side of the driveway here a little bit. Okay, so I finished coming down along the side of the garage. So I'm going to go from the corner here where the mulch stops in a diagonal across to this first tree and then just wrap around the trees in a clockwise fashion with the half inch and then tap off of that with the quarter inch and the dripper tape. But I don't want to just lay it on the top of the ground, so I'm going to try to bury it down inside the ground and get in between the blades of grass and hopefully, you know, stay away from the mower. So I'm just trying to get most of the grass out of the way and get this down to the turf so I'm not killing all the grass. Never fails, I get down about 3/4 of the way and hit a rock. We can tell how bad my soil actually is. With the ground being as hard as it is, I can't run this stake in like this. So I have to unbend this and turn it into a staple. And then it actually goes in. And I need to bend it enough that my arc here isn't gonna crush the hose. There. Now I should hit it with the mower blades. So I finally have the main line run here. I grabbed some of the dripper tubing here. So this has holes every 6 inches. And what you would do is cut this based upon the size of your root ball. And then you use a T-fitting like this to create the ring. Just push it on. So that's about where I want it. That's about the size of the root ball. And then I'll just use a little bit of 1/4 inch here plus this punch tool. And then cut a piece of 1/4 inch line. There, stick that in the main line and then push it in like that. So there we have our first ring done. So now I just have to do this 3 more times. So here we are at the end of our mainline run. So what you have to do is cap this off so that you obviously don't have water flowing out here. So they have these end caps that just like the unions and everything, you just gotta press this on and then tighten the compression fitting. So we're all sealed up here. I'll just throw a stake in here to keep this in place. So now all of our rings are in place, all of our stakes are in, we're terminated. All I have to do now is turn the water on, make sure that it works properly, and then we'll be good to go. So I turned the system on, everything looks good at the house, all the way through the main line. I don't see any leaks anywhere, so everything seems to be good. All of the drippers are doing what they're supposed to be doing, just letting out a little bit of water. Now this will run, I'll let this run for a few hours every morning, and I'll be adding on the Orbit Beehive Bluetooth automated timer so we can take care of this whenever we want to do it. If you have any questions, let me know. This is something I'm just starting to get into. We still have to build out the garden, which will be another video, because there's a lot of space there that we have to water. We spent a lot of time watering that. Like I said, if you have any questions, let me know. We have the first four done here, and then eventually we'll have another maybe 10 or 12 trees here yet to do. So I hope you enjoyed the video and you got value out of this, and I'll see you on the next one.